Hello students, now we will learn a new lesson, that is taxonomy and systematics in botany. What is taxonomy? The word taxonomy is derived from Greek, which means arrangement. Organisms are classified based on their features and they are arranged according to rules and laws. So taxonomy can be defined as the science that deals with the study of classification, including the basis, principles, rules and procedures. What is systematics? Systematics consists of taxonomy and phylogeny. So what is the differences between the taxonomy and systematics? Taxonomy is the discipline of classifying organism into groups or taxa. Whereas systematic, it's a broad field of biology that will study about the diversification of species, how species are evolved from their ancestors. Taxonomy governs the practices of naming, describing, identifying and preserving the specimens. Whereas systematic will govern the evolutionary history and the phylogenetic relationship. So classification plus nomenclature becomes, that is classifying the organism and naming it, is taxonomy. Whereas systematic is taxonomy and phylogeny, that is evolutionary history of the organism. Taxonomic hierarchy. This was introduced by Carolus Linnaeus and it is the arrangement of various taxonomic groups, various levels in descending order. It starts from the kingdom and ends in species. Kingdom is the highest level or ranks of classification, whereas species is the lowest level of classification. And in the lowest level, they have high level of similarities among the organisms. There are 7 subranks introduced in the taxonomic hierarchy. They are kingdom, division, class, order, family, genus and species. And each one will end with the suffix. Like example, kingdom phylum Magnoliophyta. Class ends with Opsida, Astropsida. Order ends with ales, that is Astrales. Family ends with C, Astraceae. Now the concept of species. We have already learned that the species is the lowest taxa of the taxonomic hierarchy, lowest level of classification, and it is the fundamental unit of taxonomic classification. Species is a population of organism which closely resemble to each other more than the other population, and they descend from a common ancestor. Some individuals of a same species can interbreed freely in nature, producing fertile offsprings. There are 3 types of species, namely morphological species, biological species and phylogenetic species. Classification of species is based on the process of evolution and the product of evolution. The process of evolution results in the biological species and they are otherwise called as isolation species. And they are nothing but the group of organisms that can interbreed and they can be reproductively isolated from other such groups. What is this product of evolution? So product of evolutions are the morphological species and phylogenetic species. Morphological species are considered as the taxonomic species. Here the individuals are similar to each other and there is no knowledge of phylogenetic history of them. Phylogenetic species are evolutionary species. They are the single lineage of the ancestor descendant population. They would have come from a single ancestor with a single line of descendants. Now, ICBN stands for International Code for Botanical Nomenclature. Assigning the name for a plant is known as nomenclature, and this is based on the rules and recommendations of the International Code for Botanical Nomenclature. ICN deals with the naming of the existing or the living species of organisms. The elementary rules for naming of a plant was first proposed by Carolus Linnaeus in 1751, and he has written in his Philosophia Botanica about it. In 1813, a detailed set of rules was proposed by A.P.D. Candolle regarding this plant nomenclature, regarding the naming of the plants. And he has written everything in his famous book called Theory Elementary de la Botanique. The ICBN is de-designated as ICN in order to separate the plant kingdom from other organisms. So ICN now stands for the International Code for Nomenclature for Algae, Fungi and Plants. And they have a set of six principles. International Botanical Congress held at different places every 6 years. 18th International Botanical Congress held in 2011 at Melbourne, Australia. So they have made many changes in this 18th International Botanical Congress. It has permitted the electronic publications of names. Secondly, it permits the use of English or Latin for the publication of the new name. And they had a concept that is one fungus, one name, one fossil and one name. It is very important because before that they had the concept of anamorph, teleomorph for fungus classification. Anamorph represent the asexual reproductive stage of a fungus, whereas teleomorph represent the sexual reproductive stage of fungus. So both were given different naming previously, but now the sexual and the asexual stages of the fungus and the fossils will be given single name. Then fourthly, as an experiment with registration of the names, new fungal description is required and it is used as an identifier from the recognized repository. And there are two recognized repositories, namely the Index Fungorum and Mycobank. Now, vernacular names. Vernacular names are otherwise called common names. They are local or the regional names given to the plants. They are often descriptive. This local name or the vernacular name help to identify the plant easily. Scientific names or the botanical names. Scientific name of a species is always binomial. So binomial means it will have two names. First name will be genus and the second name will be the species. Example for this is Oryza sativa. I hope you all have learned about it already. Now let us proceed to taxonomic aids. What are taxonomic aids? They are the tools for taxonomic study and they are useful in identification and classification of an organism. The first taxonomic tool is the keys. And keys can be of two types, that is dichotomous keys and polyclave or multi-entry keys. Dichotomous keys consist of a pair of contrasting statements known as couplet. And in this, each statement is known as a lead. By answering to these statements correctly, the plant can be identified by narrowing down the characters found in the plant. Example, the flowers are cream colored. Fruiting calyx encloses the berry. The second statement, flowers are white or violet in color and fruiting calyx not encloses the berry. So by answering yes and no for these two statements, the characteristic features of the particular plant is identified, by which the plant can be identified. In another type, they will have the keys for identification, which is polyclave or multi-entry keys. Normally, the polyclave entries are keys are implemented by a computer algorithm. Now, botanical gardens. First botanical garden was maintained by Theopratus. The first modern botanical garden was established by Luca Guini. Some of the important botanical gardens of India. The National Botanical Garden that is present in Lucknow. It consists of arboretum, which consists of nearly 500 species of trees. It was established in the year 1948. It is meant for germplasm collection and ex situ conservation, which means it is conserved out of its original place. JNTBGRI Botanical Garden, which is in Kerala. This was established in 1979. It is meant for conserving tropical plants and genetic resources. Major attraction or the special feature of it is bamboo setum. Growing of different varieties of bamboos. Nearly 69 species of bamboos are grown in this botanical garden. The third one is the National Orchidarium, which is present in Yerkad. This was established in 1963 and it is maintained by the Southern Circle of BSI, Botanical Survey of India. Major attraction of this botanical garden is insectivorous plants and orchids. The fourth botanical garden is Indian Botanical Garden in Kolkata, established in the year 1786. It is the largest and the oldest botanical garden of India. It has about 15,000 species of plant. The great banyan tree is present in this Indian Botanical Garden, Kolkata. Royal Botanic Garden, which is in Kew, England, is the largest botanical garden in the world, and it was established in the year 1760. It consists of a plant collection of about 14,000 trees in arboretum. It consists of an aquatic garden, bonsai collection means big trees can be grown in the small pots. That technique is called as bonsai technique. And bonsai collection is present in this Royal Botanical Garden of Kew. And it also has cacti collection and carnivorous plant collection in it. What is the role of these botanical gardens? Botanical gardens are meant for their aesthetic value, by which they attract lot of tourism. Example for this is the great banyan tree present in the Indian Botanical Garden at Kolkata attract more visitors per year. These botanical gardens have a wide range of species and they become the taxonomic material for botanical research. And these gardens are used for their self-instruction and demonstration purposes. It can integrate the information from different fields. Diverse fields like anatomy, embryology, phytochemistry, cytology, physiology, ecology, etc. They can also contribute the information and knowledge about diverse fields like anatomy, embryology, phytochemistry, cytology, physiology, and ecology, etc. Botanical gardens act as a conservation center for diversity. And they are helpful for free exchange of the seeds of different plant species. Botanical garden also gives information about the method of propagation of different plants. They become the center for sale of the plant material to the general public people, by which they can conserve the diversity of plants, rare species and endangered species of plants. Herbarium. Herbaria are the storehouses of the preserved plants collection. Plants are preserved in the form of pressed and dried specimens that are mounted on a sheet of paper. The preparation of herbarium consists of various steps. They are plant collection, documentation of field site data, preparation of the plant specimen, mounting herbarium specimen, herbarium labels, protection of herbarium sheets against the molds and insects that try to destroy them. What are the uses of herbarium? Herbarium provides resource material for systematic research and studies. and it is a place for orderly arrangement of various specimens. The voucher specimens serves as a references for comparing the doubtful newly collected specimens. Voucher specimens play an important role in study of floristic diversity, environmental assessment, ecological mechanism, and survey of unexplored areas. And herbarium also provides the opportunity for documenting biodiversity and the studies which are related to the field of ecology and conservation biology, etc. Each and every herbarium center will have its own acronym, which means abbreviation for it. Now let us pass on to plant classification. Classification is very essential to biology because there is a vast diversity of organisms on this earth, and to learn about each and everything is difficult. So we need to sort out them by comparing them. We have to group them, and that is what is called as classification. Many scientists have classified these plants in different ways. There are three important types of classification that are explained in our book. These are artificial classification, natural system of classification, and phylogenetic classification. Artificial system of classification is otherwise called as sexual system of classification. And this was first proposed by Carolus Linnaeus. He has outlined his classification in his book called Species Plantarum, which he published in the year 1753. And his classification was based on the number, union, and length and distribution of the stamens in the flowers. And he has classified only the flowering plants. These classes were further subdivided on the basis of the carpal characteristics into orders. And so his system of classification, artificial system of classification, was otherwise called a sexual system of classification. This is the book page of his classification. First, he classified the plants based on the number of stamens, their union, their adhesion, cohesion, etc. And afterwards, and these classes were classified into orders based on the carpel, based on the type of the carpels. However, the artificial system of classification was not followed for a long time, for the reason that is totally unrelated plants were kept together in a single group, whereas the closely related plants were placed in widely separated groups. Example, the Gingiberaceae family of monocotyledons and the Anacardiaceae family of dicotyledons were placed under the class called Monandria because these two family plants, they possess single stamen. Similarly, Prunus was classified along with cactus because of the same number of stamens, but they are of different types of plants. Next came the natural system of classification, and this was proposed by two English botanists, namely George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. Their classification was published in the book called Genera Plantarum in three volumes. They described about nearly 202 families and 7,569 genera and about 97,205 species of plants were described in their books of three volumes. Their major classes are class 1 Dicotyledonae, class 2 Gymnospermae, class 3 Monocotyledonae. Class 1 Dicotyledonae consists of the plants that contains two cotyledons in their seeds, and their leaves have reticulate venation with a taproot system, and the flowers are normally tetramerous or pentamerous. That means they have the floral whorls in the sets of 4 or 5. They all come under the class Dicotyledonae. This class is again divided into three subclasses, namely subclass 1 Polypetalae, subclass 2 Gamopetalae, and subclass 3 Monoclamidae. The subclass 1 Polypetalae, here the plants have free petals and diclamidous flowers. That means they have the separate distinct sepals and petals. That is denoted by the term dichlamydias. And this is further divided into three series, namely thalamiflorae, dicyflorae and calyciflorae. Thalamiflorae, the plants have the flowers with dome shape or conical shaped thalamus with the ovary superior in position. They have the superior ovary and dome or conical shaped thalamus. Then they come under the series called thalamiflorae. And this has 6 orders and 34 families. Series number 2 is dicyflorae. Here the term itself tells it has the disc shaped thalamus, and here also the ovary is superior, and it includes 4 orders and 23 families. And the series 3 is calyciflorae. Calyci term for cup shaped thalamus. The thalamus is cup shaped with inferior or sometimes with half inferior ovary, and this includes 5 orders and 27 families. The subclass 2 of the dicotyledonae is called gamopetalae. So gamopetalae plants will have united petals. They are either completely fused or partly fused together. And they are dichlamydias, which means they have the sepals separately and petals separately. That is calyx and corolla as two whorls. And it is further divided into three series, namely the series 1 inferae. Here the flowers are epigynous. Epigynous means inferior ovary. They include 3 orders and 9 families. The second series of gamopetalae is heteromerae. Here hypogynous ovary, that means superior ovary but with more than 2 corpels, then it is called heteromerae. The heteromerae series consists of 3 orders and 12 families. The third series is called bicarpellate. Here they have the superior or hypogynous ovary but they have only 2 corpels. Bicarpellate includes 4 order and 24 families. The third subclass of class dicotyledonae is monochlamydae. The plants will have incomplete flowers. They will be either having apetalous, that is without petals, or undifferentiated calyx and corolla, that is monochlamydae. They will not be having distinct calyx and corolla. They will be similar, and it is called as tepals, and the whorl is called as perianth. And it consists of 8 series and 36 families. The second class is called gymnospermae. Here the plants will have naked seed. They are naked seeded plants. Under this class they have 3 families, namely Nietaceae, Coniferaceae and Cycadaceae. Class 3 is called monocotyledonae. These plants contain only 1 cotyledon in their seeds, and the leaves will have parallel venation and fibrous root system will be present. And the flower is said to be trimerous. They have the floral whorls in the sets of 3. Class monocotyledonae has 7 series and 34 families. Bentham and Hooker's classification is still in use. It is the best system of classification and it is widely used because the description of the plants are quite accurate and reliable. It is easy to follow and it is used as a key for the identification of plants in several herbaria of the world. The next system of classification is called phylogenetic system of classification. So this was proposed by Adolf Engler and Karl Prandt. After the emergence of Charles Darwin's Origin of Species, the phylogenetic system of classification was proposed. It is one of the earliest system to classify the entire plant kingdom, and it is done jointly by 2 people, Adolf Engler and Karl Prandt. And they published their classification in their monumental work called Die Naturalischen Pflanzenfamilien, which came in 23 volumes. Here they have classified the division embryo phyta, which is siphonogamma. Siphonogamma are the plants with embryos and pollen tubes. They will have the embryos and pollen tubes. And this is classified into subdivisions in gymnosperma and angiosperma. Angiosperma is again classified into classes called monocotyledonae and dicotyledonae. Monocotyledonae includes 14 orders and dicotyledonae includes 44 orders. And dicotyledonae is again classified into Archiclamidae and Metachlamidae. Archiclamidae apopetalae, that is the petals are free. Here the corolla is polypetalous. The petals are free. Perianth will be present in single whorl or double whorls, two whorls. And they include 33 orders and 201 families in the Archiclamidae. In Metachlamidae, the corolla is camopetalous, that means the petals are united. And the perianth will be present in two whorls. They include 11 orders and 57 families. Next type of classification, that is called Arthur-Cronquist system of classification. Arthur-Cronquist, he is an eminent American taxonomist. He proposed this phylogenetic classification of the flowering plants. And he presented his work in 1968 in the book titled The Evolution and Classification of Flowering Plants. Here he classified the plants broadly based on the principles of phylogeny. Cronquist classified angiosperm into two main classes, namely Magnoliopsida, which contains dicotyledonous plants, and Liliopsida, which contains monocotyledonous plants. Anyhow, Cronquist system of classification was not able to persist for a long time because this system is not very useful for the identification of the plants and cannot be adopted by the herbaria due to high phylogenetic nature. Next came the angiosperm phylogeny group. This is the most recent classification of flowering plants, which is also based on the phylogenetic data. In short, they call it as APG. There are four versions of angiosperm phylogenetic group classification as APG1, APG2, APG3 and APG4. And they have been published in the year 1998, 2003, 2009 and 2016 respectively. And they have recognized the monophyletic group, which is based on the information which is received from various disciplines of biology. And they also have taken the reference strongly on the molecular data with respect to the DNA sequences, especially of two chloroplast genes, namely ATPase beta subunit and ribulose 1,5 biphosphate carboxylase large subunit, and one nuclear gene which is called as nuclear ribosomal 18S DNA. The recent system of APG, which is the APG4, in this classification, they have classified all the angiosperm into 64 orders and 416 families. Out of these 416 families, 259 are represented in India itself. And this is the outline of APG4 classification. And it is classified into three clades. They are early angiosperms, monocots and eudicots. Early angiosperms are classified into 8 orders and 26 families, and they consist of ANA clades, magnolids and chloranthales. ANA represent these clades. Here the seeds are generally with two cotyledons. They have the ethereal oils and the leaves are always simple. Each floral whorls with many parts. Carpels are usually free, etc. The second clade, which is called as monocots, consists of 11 orders and 77 families. Here the seeds are with single cotyledons. They have the primary root, which is short-lived. Leaves are simple with parallel venation. Vascular bundles are scattered in the stem, etc. The third clade is called as eudicot, and it consists of 45 orders and 313 families. This is again classified into early diverging eudicots, super rosids and super astrids. APG system is an evolving system and it may undergo changes periodically based on the new sets of data. So classification reflects the state of our knowledge at a given point of time. It will continue to change when we acquire new information.